In this screencast, we're going to derive the rate expression for Michaelis-Menten kinetics. And what they correspond to is we have an enzyme reacts with a substrate. It's a reversible reaction to form an enzyme substrate complex. This complex then decomposes to reform the enzymes. The enzyme is a catalyst reaction and to make the product. And we're going to analyze this by using the idea of rate determining steps. So we're going to say that the second step is the rate determining step. And we're also going to say that we have a low concentration of our product P, so it's not going to enter into the rate expression. Well, rate determining step says if the second step is rate determining, the first then is in quasi-equilibrium. Clearly some reaction is taking place, but what we're assuming is that it's very close to equilibrium, so we can write an equilibrium expression. Now what we're going to do, what the convention is, we're going to write the equilibrium expression for the reverse reaction. So Km is a dissociation constant, and so concentration of the two reactants over the concentration of the product. So that's just the inverse of the equilibrium constant for the reaction as written, or it's the equilibrium constant for the reverse reaction. Km is referred to as the dissociation constant. The idea of rate determining step says now the rate that we form product is the rate constant of this second step times the concentration of the complex. And we can get the concentration of the complex from this equilibrium expression and from one other piece of information. And that information is that the total amount of enzyme, total concentration of enzyme, doesn't change. Either it's free or it's part of this complex. And so we're going to take this equation plus this equation to get an expression for the concentration of the enzyme substrate complex, because this is not something we measure. We want our rate expression in terms of things that we measure. If we make the substitution that the enzyme concentration, the free enzyme concentration, would just be Km ES complex over substrate. So that's just rearranging this equation, and then the second term is not changed. But what I have now, I can factor out the enzyme substrate concentration. Let me do that. So I factored out, and I can rearrange this so I'm solving for the enzyme substrate concentration. Okay, so now I have a term I can substitute back into my rate expression, and so the rate becomes K. I have E total. Remember, that's a constant. And the denominator looks like that. So what is the normal convention? Is we call this term V max, the maximum rate. K is a constant at a given temperature, and ET, total enzyme concentration in a given system, is constant. Now we typically rearrange this to put it in a slightly different form by multiplying the numerator and denominator by the substrate concentration. So the numerator is V max times the substrate concentration. Denominator then is the substrate concentration plus this dissociation constant. This then is our final answer. These is what the Michaelis-Menten rate expression looks like. If we have a low concentration of S, then it's first order. And if we have a high concentration of S, then concentration of S is large relative to Km, then it's going to be zero order. So the idea, this is a fairly common type kinetics that's observed for enzyme reactions.